G'day, I'm Ash. Today we're going to be talking about Twitch Drops. And as of 4.5 hours ago, as this video has gone live, Twitch Drops has finally ended. Or at least for the first weekend. If you don't want to get your hands on a Panzer 3J, well, it's a bit late now. You can't necessarily get that vehicle at all. That being said, though, next weekend and the weekend after, you've got an opportunity to get a P40 with a Twitch Drop skin and a riverboat or patrol boat of some kind. It's a coastal fleet vehicle only. But aside from the turbo snail decal, which is utterly fantastic, and maybe a couple of other things, would it be nice for Gaijin to introduce intermittent rewards so that you still knew that your account was connected instead of watching for 4 hours and then realizing, oh no, my account wasn't linked? We had lots of cases of that kind of thing happening. It was quite irritating in a way. It also was a bit subject to RNG in the way that Gaijin claimed it wasn't. The event was supposed to give you a decal, and it was also supposed to give you a tank at 10 hours maximum. But there was already, sadly, a lot of things that might have gone wrong on both the system and from the users. Stuff like accounts disconnecting, viewers muting the stream, and from the player, which caused Twitch not to count them as active people. But that being said, though, essentially, you watched a stream, you linked your account, and you got free stuff. That is a net positive, in my opinion. Not only that, you're exposing the, I guess, lower-end creators to a wider berth and a wider audience, which again was fantastic for, I guess, you know, community engagement. It allowed a lot of people to interact with bigger audiences than they would ever have dreamed of, and as a result, it generated more interest in Twitch streamers broadly. But I feel that even though I did 2 streams, and most other content creators did 3 or 4, I feel that the majority of my sessions in the 2 12-hour streams that I did over the last days, I felt like I was repeating myself consistently. And as a result, that's kind of a sad thing, and it's a failure of the system. Obviously, you had a lot of people just ended up by muting the stream or muting the tab. That is perfectly fine. You're there specifically to get your rewards, then you can go log off and go do other things. A lot of you were interested enough that you stuck around and you actually sort of expansionally, basically stuck with that particular streamer, and that is utterly fantastic. However, I don't know that the retention on the Twitch drops will be that long, which is probably why Gaijin are experimenting with this 3-week sort of system over 3 weekends. Now, that's not necessarily a bad thing. However, it is a bit of a drain when you've got other projects and the work in the background, but that's just content creation aside. People don't realize that it's incredibly hard work in order to put content out on the internet. And if you do it well, like many other content creators out there that are not me, because I haven't yet found my groove with this game, I tend to have periods of content is up and streams are all up and that's about it. But otherwise, for the most part, it was an enjoyable experience, I think. And with Twitch Drops concluding for War Thunder, at least, I wanted to really say a big congratulations to all those who did stream the events and saw at least some growth during it. It was a long time coming, but good work everyone else who managed to actually make something of this, or at least make a followership. The problem is retention rates. Are these viewership going to stay? No, it's not, because obviously we're only at 3 weekends. When the first Twitch drops came around, it was only 1 weekend. But I feel that that was probably just enough, and it should have been conduced into 1 weekend only. I understand why War Thunder and Twitch have decided to do it in the way they have, expanding the player base and expanding the growth on Twitch, and obviously trying to figure out what is best for the community. But having said that, I think the people that really won here were the streamers and people who found their new favorite local streamer or their new content creator of choice, I suppose. Which begs the question, did you guys participate in the Twitch drops? If you did you find someone that you enjoyed? If you didn't, why didn't you participate? And more importantly, is there any feedback that you would give to War Thunder based on the Twitch drop events? Obviously, a lot of you are probably going to say just reduce the time reward for your vehicle, because essentially you're getting a skinned version of a Panzer III and a skinned version of a P40, and the same with the vessel. So would it be wise for them to introduce some intermittent events and some sort of rewards, for example, boosters or Silver Lion things, or maybe even an occasional drop of premium or some other sort of thing? I guess they experimented with that initially, but suffice to say that this doesn't cost Gaijin anything. It's a copy-paste of another vehicle. It's a collector's item now, and is that a good thing? Yeah, probably. But at the same time, I feel that I don't know. It's a bit weird in this regard. And I just think it's unfortunate that despite Gaijin claiming that it was only 10 hours to get the vehicle, it, well, which was already, in my honest opinion, way too much watch time, we then tell our viewers this, and now content creators and streamers look like we're the bad ones because, well, over 10 hours and still no vehicle for some users. You see how this could create a problem here? But again, it was really sort of a strange event, and we've got two more events coming up as well. So, if you haven't followed me on Twitch, or you haven't followed me on Twitter to see when I'm live, I highly recommend you do that. And in fact, you know what? I may as well make a video of some of the streamers that I would recommend. In fact, that list will probably include streamers that don't even have an audience. And due to Twitch drops, I've only just realized who they are and some of them I like. So, to summarize, has War Thunder done a good job? Yes and no. Is this a negative thing or a positive thing? Probably a net positive for the wider community and for exposure of streamers that were in dire need of some, extra view boosting towards War Thunder's live stream community, which is a massive side of content creation. And while I am still learning the ropes as a somewhat incompetent streamer, I've got a speech impediment, I have terrible graphics currently, my graphics card is dying, I need to sort out a whole host of other Twitch-related things. My main focus is really YouTube and making videos. I like doing that more than I do live streaming. And I have the utmost respect for streamers now. Having done it over the last 6-7 months, even the last Twitch drops, which were the very first ones for War Thunder, it was an incredible eye-opener to the world of streaming. And I've talked about this in Crash with Ash and several other types of videos. In fact, you've seen live stream content put up on my channel before. I'm not new to this, but if I did it more consistently, I'd probably find that I'd get better results. And while I might be chasing that partnership, there are plenty of other streamers that are certainly a lot better than I am, and I highly recommend that you go and check out War Thunder Twitch category to see if you can find someone that you like. Anyway, my name is Ash. That's all I have for you today. Short video, I know, but I think it's rather relevant. Anyway, catch you in the next one, boys. Bye-bye.